levo rotatory compounds, they are indicated with small d or minus. So here these two are called as optical isomers, and phenomenon for the existence of optical isomers are called as optical isomerism. Let us consider one more example to explain optical isomerism. I would like to consider CO NH3 taken 4 Cl2 plus. So to explain optical isomerism concept, I would like to consider an example of coordination compound in which cobalt is the central atom with binded with 4 ammonia and 2 chlorine ligands, and coordination sphere present with the positive charge. Again, it is due to coordination number 6, the geometry exhibited by this complex is hexahedral geometry. So during its hexahedral geometry, CO, NH3, 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 chlorine, chlorine, NH3. So it is a possible cis isomer of the given metal complex. While we are going to observe it in mirror, it shows CO, NH3, 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 Cl, Cl, NH3. So this metal complex is a mirror image to first isomer. Of course, these two are cis isomers only, because the two chlorines are simultaneously present onto the central metal atom here. But in the previous explanation, that is in geometrical isomers, in the given metal complex, if the two chlorine atoms are present opposite side, NH3, NH3 and NH3, what is this? It is the trans form of this metal complex, trans. Whereas what are these two? Cis optical or mirror images of cis isomer of the given coordination metal complex. Here it is optically inactive. Optically inactive, that means it cannot form optical isomers due to optical inactivity. What is optical inactivity means? Those isomers which cannot rotate plane of polarized light either right side or left side are called as optically inactive isomers. So these optically inactive isomers are not at all useful to discuss under optical isomerism. That means the same molecular formula, but the trans isomer due to optical inactivity, it never produces optical isomers. Whereas the cis form of this compound can exhibit two optical isomers. In this, the first isomer is dextrorotatory. What is dextrorotatory? It rotates plane polarized light right side, so it is D isomer. Whereas the second one is L levorotatory, and it indicates with small L. So this is optical isomerism. Once again, the transform is optically inactive because absence of chiral character. So how to identify whether it is optically active or optically inactive? The simple way: if plane polarized light, the plane of symmetry present in the given geometry, it is optically inactive, or center of symmetry present, it is optically inactive. Because if plane of symmetry or center of symmetry exhibited by any coordination complex, it is achiral. All achiral molecules are optically inactive. Whereas if either plane of symmetry or center of symmetry are absent, such are chiral and optically active. Those optically active compounds only discussed under optical isomerism concept. So these two are stereoisomers of coordination compounds. Whereas one more important classification or types of coordination isomers of coordination compounds are the second one, structural isomers or structural isomerism. One more type of major isomerism exhibited by coordination compounds or structural isomerism. Once again, isomerism in coordination compounds. The coordination compounds mainly exhibit two types of isomerisms. They are stereoisomerism and structural isomerism. Again, two types of stereoisomerisms are possible or exhibited by coordination compounds. They are geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. Similarly, come to the second type of isomerism that are exhibited by coordination compounds are structural isomerism. So what is structural isomerism? The two or more isomers of a same molecule having same molecular formula but differ in their connectivity of ligands are called as structural isomers. Here, four types of structural isomerisms are possible. The structural isomerisms, four types of structural isomerism are possible in coordination compounds. One is linkage isomerism. Linkage isomerism. And second one is coordination isomerism. Coordination isomerism. And third one, ionization isomerism. And the last one is hydrate isomerism. So here, four types of isomerisms generally considered under structural isomerisms. So come to what is linkage isomerism. Actually, the linkage isomerism resulting from those metal complexes which consists of ambidentate ligands.